Well, we are on our way towards probing the mysteries of the blue third, which is we're using a C harp, we're playing cross harp, and we're trying to get that note that is the foundation of really profoundly bluesy playing on the instrument. Now, you know, you guys all know how to wail on that four-hole draw. But it's amazing how many players, even some fairly good ones, don't really attack the whole one below the four, which is to say the three draw, really get that blue third working for them. And so that's what we're going to try to troubleshoot and work with today. And when I last left you, I was saying that what you want to do is you want to maybe begin doing this by tonguing the unbent three-hole draw. And then begin to change the shape of your mouth in a way that makes that pitch drop a little bit while you're continuing to tap your tongue lightly on the roof of your mouth. Now, I find that my jaw, when I'm starting to try that to bend like that, is sort of feeling a little tension. You want to try shifting your jaw around. You want to try, of course, as you're tapping your tongue, you want to try sort of pulling it back and down and sort of up closer to the roof of your mouth as you would doing any kind of a bend. I can't, you know, I'm not going to explain how to bend per se here. I'm trying to explain how to apply the bending force that you know how to apply as somebody who already does a little bit of bending. If you don't know how to bend, God help you. I don't know. I can't teach that. Okay. Once you get that note that way, I want you to move between that note and the two draw. I want you to tongue the three draw with that little bend that this we're doing a blue third, and then slide to the two draw. And then you can begin to do a song like Spoonful. That spoonful. And what I'd like you to do, I know you're not a good singer, neither am I, okay? I'd like you, in any case, to try to sing that line. That spoonful. Now the two draw, that's your root. That's the full. That spoonful. That spoonful. And you may find that you can begin to feel the bluesiness of that blue third as a little kind of rising edge on the word spoon. That spoonful. Now, if I did the word spoon as a major third rather than a blue third, that spoonful, spoonful, that spoonful. I sound like one of the Princeton Nassoons. Oh, that spoon, you know, bright and snappy. Well, we're trying to play blues, okay? So that's not the note you want to get. That spoonful, that spoon, that spoon, that spoonful. And if you get it just right, you'll get the sound. You'll hear it. It'll sound. It'll addict you. It's an addictive sound. And those of you who can bend the two draw, I'd love you to try to combine the bent two, release it into the two, and then go up to the blue third. Because there's so many blues melodies that use just those three notes. Rolling and tumbling. Or now, before I go any further, I'm going to put the harp down and remind you of one crucial thing, because this is not obvious to everybody who picks up the instrument. It takes not only a lot of dedication and a lot of precision to play this thing, but it takes a lot of strength. And it takes a strength that you need, kind of what I'd call power in reserve. It's not like you have to apply the strength at every moment, particularly if you play, of course, out-of-the-box marine bands like me. It really does take strength. But you have to be willing to work for it. By the same token, the blue third is a tricky note because it's not just about hammering on it. If you hammer on it, you're going to do what most people do when they say, oh, I bend the three hole. And they bend it too far. And that's why this is an important note, because it takes strength, but the harder you pull, the more air you pull through the harp, the more you need to subtly release a little bit of bending energy, right? Because the more air you're pulling through, the more a given mouth shape is going to cause that note to bend down. So if you're playing really light, your mouth's going to be in one shape. If I just have my mouth in that shape and pull more air through, the note's going to go down. So as I pull harder, I've got to release the bending energy a little. This is tough, right? This instrument is tough. It's not easy. Okay. Let's talk about the blue third in a couple of other places on the harp, okay? Those of you who overblow, or I know I'm already have lost 90% of my audience. That would be the six overblow. But the problem is the six overblow is really just the minor third. It's not really the minor third, but with a little bit of pitch boosted up. If you're a good overblower, Jason can do this. I can't do this. You can actually get the true blue third. But the other place that you can get it, it's tough on a C harp, so if you don't mind, I'm going to move to an A harp. This is not a great A harp. When you have a harp that doesn't really respond on the three hole, take a little bit of spit, get a little spit in your mouth, spit in the three hole, and then draw it out. Sometimes that'll help, especially on wood-combed harps. All right. The other place you can get the blue third is all the way at the top of the harp, believe it or not, that 10-hole blow. This is more for you advanced intermediate players, right? But it's there to get. What's interesting is that you can get the major third. Well, the 10-hole blow, if I don't put any bend, is the interval of the fourth. If I bend half a step, I'm getting the major third. Like, if I bend a little further, you get the blue third. And so that's what I call the magic dick note, the note on Whammer Jammer where he, I'm looking at my time and I'm saying, we're all through with the blue third. Do you know what it is now? Can you play it for me? Let me play you one last lick on the C harp. I'll play 12 bar blues and I'll use the blue third a lot. I'll do a slow blues. Lesson. I'm going to come back with the 10 principles of improvisation. See you down the road.